Five, four, three, two, one.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the moment of silence.
Stop! Don't sit down yet!
Dress code check!
PCs, welcome back to Bears in the News. I'm Ross Harrison. Today is Wednesday, October 21st, 2020. Congratulations to these following students for receiving their Microsoft Office Specialties Certifications and Award. Steve Ruger, William Moon, Tracy Thompson, Miller Tompkins, Nathan Calza, Jordan Tucker, Brent Bajan, and Harley Costa. Students, remember that when you check out during the school day, you must sign out at the front office. Also remember that lunch detention has moved this year. Its new location in the large commons area hallway near the exit to the small courtyard. Don't forget, FCA meets tomorrow morning at 7:40 in the auditorium, and they invite everyone to be a part and to bring a friend. It's a great way to start the day.
I'm TJ Markwith, and here's the rest of the news. Makeup Picture Day will be Wednesday, November 4th. Anyone who has not yet taken a picture for the yearbook will need to do so on that day. And for seniors, your formal picture will be that day at a cost of $25. Please see Ms. Milena or a yearbook staff member for more information. Freshmen who had Ms. Callahan last year need to pick up their art canvas painting from the art show in the PCHS art room as soon as possible. The Grizzly Cafe in the Media Center is now serving hot beverages and snacks. You can get them between classes at lunch or while your class is in the Media Center. The menu includes coffee and hot chocolate for $2, muffins for $1.50, bagged popcorn, and grandma's cookies for $1, and chewy granola bars and Rice Krispie treats for 50 cents each. Grab it and growl. Now here's a look at sports.
Hi, I'm Jake Brown, and Bears football is back in action this weekend, traveling to Brantley County. That's this Friday at 7:30 in Caney Bay. Tickets are $8 and will be on sale during lunch this week. Wrestling tryouts are next Monday on October 26th at 4 p.m. in the old high school gym. Only football players and cross-country runners are exempt. Please see Coach Hilton for more information. Attention, Bear swimmers. The pool at the YMCA is closed today for maintenance. Stay tuned to Bears DEN as well as social media for updates. Now, here's a look at weather.
I'm Olivia Colley with today's forecast. We will have a high of 83 and a low of 67 with a 60% chance of rain. Happy birthday today to Jeremy Choate, Gavin Jones, Madeline O'Connell, and a special happy birthday to Miss Melissa Thomas. Hope you all have a great day.
I'm Tara Duncan, and here's what's cooking today in the Bear Cafe. Buffalo Ranch Chicken Sandwich, Steak Nuggets, Rice with Stewed Tomatoes, Black Eyed Peas, PB&J Encrustable, Side Salad with Homemade Ranch, Smart Mouth Pizza, and Grab and Go Salad. Here's today's thought of the day. The most important thing in communication is hearing what isn't said. Peter Drucker. The PBS word of this month is communication. Keep demonstrating your ability to be responsible, respectful, and safe. Thanks, and go Bears!
Good morning, my name is Nathaniel Perez. Unsung hero Sylvia Mendez paved the way for desegregation of schools in the U.S. when in third grade she became the first Mexican-American to go to an all-white school in California. Her parents sued in the landmark case Mendez versus Westminster in 1947, successfully desegregating all public schools in California. This was the first case in which the U.S. ruled in favor of desegregation and paved the way for the more well-known Supreme Court case, Brown versus Board of Education.
Buenos días, mi nombre es Cayetano Santana Franco. La ciudad anónima Silvia Méndez allanó el camino para la desegregación de las escuelas en los Estados Unidos, cuando en tercer grado se convirtió en la primera mexicoamericana en ir a una escuela para blancos en California. Sus padres demandaron en el caso histórico Méndez versus Westminster en 1947, logrando eliminar la segregación de todas las escuelas públicas de California. Este fue el primer caso en el que Estados Unidos falló a favor de la eliminación de la segregación y allanó el camino para el caso más conocido de la Corte Suprema, Brown versus Board of Education.